What's going on, everybody? Happy New Year. If I haven't told you already, this dude right here, Dari Ho. This season he was 16-0. This is season 5, by the way. There's been a lot of changes in my franchise going forward. First of all, Glitchy Goon is no longer the CEO. The new CEO is now OU Want Some Too. I'm currently about to assign a customer service representative to the new league, so we're going in a new direction. Pretty much, you guys may be familiar with Dari Ho. I guess some people may consider him a pretty solid Madden player. I consider him a bitch. But that's another story. We'll go ahead and get right into the game. But today, man, okay, let me just let you know the date. Today is January 2nd, 2015. And I know you guys are familiar with Tank in the Madden community. He sent me this picture of a guy threatening to IP boot him. And it's just like, you know, the thing about it is this. Like, I told you guys before in the past about VPNs, you know, virtual private networks. The thing about those, though, are they're very complicated to use. You know, I use them. You know, pretty much you just give somebody a very false reading of your IP address. That's only to prevent, oh, shit. Yo, I don't understand. Yeah, take that sack. Take it back for 6, man. You should have got up and ran it back for 6, man. This dude is, and then I started running stupid shit. That was my problem this game. I ran dumb plays that, you know, he was designing his blitzes for, and it was just real stupid. And, you know, I ended up taking a lot of field goals, and it was a real stupid fucking, it was just real ridiculous, because Dari Ho, he knows how it goes, though. But he has me. I don't think I've beaten him. I think I'm 0-2 against him. I was definitely, he's just a fucking bum, though. He just really disgusts me. But either way, so with the IP addresses, it's just pretty much, it's for those, VPNs, it helps you as far as your real location. You know, they can still boot you. I don't know why he wasn't sacked there. Johnny Manziel is a stud in this game. Meanwhile, he's really shitty in real life, and he throw parties, and then all his teammates come to fucking meetings late, and they all get fucking benched. But that's another story. Good shit, EA. Hashtag thanks, Madden. But the bottom line about the situation is this. The VPN is just, it's more for my Call of Duty dudes that, you know, they were getting swatted and shit like that. That's just basically for them to make it so that they'll send the police to the wrong people. You know what I'm saying? As far as Madden, you're going to be booted because they can still see the IP. And the IP that, you know, technically, they really don't boot you, is what I meant to say. Like, they'll boot the IP address that they see. Why did he drop that? Oh, he caught it? All right, good shit. You know what I'm saying? So, the only thing that I want to let you guys understand, though, is it's very complicated to use. That's what I meant to say. Like, pretty much, I have a couple of my friends that use it for Call of Duty because of the swatting situation. But for Madden, it definitely, because I don't know, I probably should have got booted a whole lot of times. I've been playing, you know, live streaming on Gmod as well for a while, and I've been fortunate enough to not have been booted. Now, I don't know if people are booting my false IP address, and that's why I'm not being booted, but I don't know. But the thing about VPNs, though, it's a little complex to use because you have to reset everything as far as your internet and everything to go along with it every time you log in. You know what I'm saying? And it's always going to, pretty much, you can't really have it set because it changes your IP every time. So if you have a YouTube account and shit like that, and you have the double verification, which you should have, where they call your cell phone to verify where you are, you're going to always have your cell phone with you to always verify if you're using YouTube and any, like, Facebook and all that shit. Because I do everything with double verification and triple verification and your mom's verification. Because you got to just make it harder for people to do it. Can they still do it if they want to? Absolutely. But you don't want to make it easy. You don't want to, you know what I'm saying? If you're going to get raped, you don't want to make sure that your butthole is extra fresh. You know what I'm saying? So I just try to help the community understand that there's other ways to avoid the bullshit. Now, what should happen is these internet providers, I don't know what the fuck kind of throw that was right there. And then this one right here is a touchdown. Look how far ahead he is. And he just, yo, man, the game just glitches up. Hashtag thanks, Madden. But that's besides the point. What I'm trying to tell you is this, though. There are other ways to get it done to prevent IP booting, but people don't take it as serious unless they are, you know, in that business. You know what I'm saying? Like, people that are hackers and stuff like that, they use different type of firewalls, different type of things to make sure that you can track them. But that type of software and information is not available to the regular public. So what I'm saying is it's there, but it hasn't been that big of an issue overall. So people don't take consideration to try to fix the problem because it's not on EA Sports. Because your IP is freedom of information. Bro, you can see everybody's IP. The shit is there. Unless you have programs to prevent that. You understand what I'm saying? So, and there are programs that prevent it, but what I'm saying is it adds a lot more to to your everyday hustle. Like when you get on to anything, you always have to do a double verification of everything. It's always gonna be more shit. It's a lot more things to do. But if that's one route to go for the guys that keep on getting DC'd. And that's why I have an issue with Shaka 360. You know what I'm saying? Shaka 360, Koopa Go Live, all these guys. Because your IP booting, but your commentators, your IP booting, and you don't give a fuck. And that's my issue. You know what I'm saying? Like, other than that, you know, I really wouldn't have a lot of issue with these guys, but the game is so flawed. Madden 15 is such a flawed game. So when you now put in work, you know what I'm saying? You might end up getting a BZ ebook, and you know what I'm saying? A guy, he's a bum, but he has very good ebooks, BZ and Tweezy. You know, they'll show you how to do blitzes, but BZ don't know what the fuck he's doing when it comes to a blitz. But he has really good blitzes, you know what I'm saying? But at the same time, whatever you choose to get, when you get your game up, and then now when you finally got your game up, a motherfucker glitches you? That shit is crazy. Yo, it's fucking crazy. You know what I'm saying? Like, bro, it doesn't make any sense. So it's just like, yo, what the fuck, man? And that's my issue with these guys that are commentators that glitch. Like, bro, you can't make it seem as if it's okay and you're just doing whatever you want to do. It doesn't make any sense. And you know what I'm saying? I'm not going to stop voicing my opinion because listen, if I'm getting my ass whipped, which I have on stream, and I'm getting blown the fuck out, I want to be able to enjoy it in the privacy of my own home in order my cheeks are protected. You know what I'm saying, bro? I don't want to be, oh, bro, let me go ahead and glitch this guy. Like, bro, I'm not built like that, and nobody in the community should be as well. You know what I'm saying? Listen, you take the loss or you quit. I don't know what quit means. I don't know how to get to that button. I don't know what goes on, but to each its own. If you're going to do it like that, it's much easier to just quit instead of trying to glitch somebody, going through all that shit, because it doesn't really do anything. You know what I'm saying? Because once you quit, that's it, bro. You on a whole new realm now. You know what I'm saying? Like realm, like fucking Game of Thrones. Like you dealing with realms. Like you a whole nother character. But it's better to do that than to glitch, to be known as a glitcher. Like to be known as a quitter. All right, bro, the dude gonna quit. So dudes will play you. You know what I'm saying? Like, all right, we'll play him. He gonna quit. But you know, when you known as a glitcher or a Shaka 360 or a Koopa Go Live type dude, you know what I'm saying, bro? It's not cool. You know what I'm saying? It's very unfortunate, man. It's very unfortunate that we got to start the new year off like that. But IP booting is something that's it's very, very minimal when you look at the corporate stage, because they have no reason to try to make it a situation to where they actually attack people that glitch. And until people get together and come together and say, look, you know what, EA? Let's go down to Florida and see what's good. Yeah, that first down killed me, bro. I didn't really have Rundy, but it was a good game. I fucking was in the red zone a lot of times. I took field goals. This guy's a certified bitch, though. But congratulations to the Rams and Dari Ho. He got me, bro. That rhymed. It wasn't intentional. So, you know, it's the way it goes sometimes, man. I got my ass reamed, and it is what it is. But we'll see. He's in a new franchise, so we'll see what goes on with that if I run into him again. But it was definitely a good game. You have to score in the red zone in the Super Bowl. You can't take field goals. That's what I learned. So, for now on, I'll just be going for it on fucking fourth down. I don't give a fuck. Or I have a new offense now, so that'll probably come in handy. But other than that, it was a great season, man. Thank you to Dari Pro for going out there, playing all your games, do what you had to do, always being around. Shout out to the new CEO, you want some too. The customer service representative is coming soon. But thank you to everybody that made this league a success. Playing their games, doing what they had to do, coming out, getting your ass whipped, not quitting, not DC glitching. It has to start somewhere, bro. It has to start somewhere. I'm glad to be a part of the people that, be one of the people that weren't scared when I had no subs to say something about it and to let people know that Koopa's a glitcher, Shaka 360's a glitcher, and whatever, bro. It is what it is, because until we stop it, it's going to continue to go on. We don't got to go and find where he's at and beat the shit out of him. We just have to make people understand we don't support it. So we don't support whatever those gentlemen do. And whoever else we find out that's doing it, we don't support what they do. You see what happened Black Friday, where people decided not to spend money? They lost money. So let's not go ahead and say, oh yeah, bro, yo, he's a glitcher, and then still go watch his videos or still go do whatever. You can't support it. Once you choose to support it, it's like nothing's ever gonna be done. And that's the bottom line. And at some point, we have to take that away from them. We have to take that away from them. We have to make it so that these fucking people understand that it's not cool to do it, and these internet providers provide extra security to actually mask it, just like they could block a phone call. Until next time, enjoy the new year. It's a lot more coming. One love.